Hi friends, so the next topic is the constructor-destructor order. Just to run down memory lane, constructor is for constructing and destructor is for destroying the code. So in constructor, the initialization topics like DB opening, file opening or memory allocation, what all prerequisites are needed, it does all that. The destructor does the exact opposite of that. So now in inner runs, how do we do constructor is the question. So now we have weapon and shotgun. In what sequence, whether it has to be constructed here or in the other, that is what we're going to see. So before doing anything, let's think about it logically and expect what result you want, like an expected result and an actual result. So now for constructing, how do we do it? Like in buildings, we build the ground floor, then the first floor, second floor and so on. Similarly, we first create the base class code, then the derived class code and so on. Now, if you want to destroy it, how do? We have to start from top and come down. So if we destroy the base, it will be a mess. So first derived, then the base. So this is basically logic. So let's see the demo. Weapon.cpp. In this, we will check the cout mode. So print and write, I am in base constructor endl. So control C, control S. And destructor, I am in base destructor, and in shotgun we write, I am in derived. Again, I am in derived. This is useful when we see the virtual destructor. So see the sequence and keep. So now in derived class, we are going to create an object. So first we call the base class, create it and it comes. This is the sequence. So the expected result is first the base constructor column, and when destroying, first the derived, then the base. So let's run it and see the output. So see, first we create the base, then the derived, which is like, let's say, the first floor, and when destroying, first we target the derived class and only then the base class. So that's all for this class. See you in the next video. Thank you.